Hey man, welcome back to Man Time. Today's episode, we've got a big problem. My backhoe, the hydraulics are completely out on it. Let me start it up here, show you what it's doing, and then we'll go to start digging into this hydraulic system. I'm fairly confident it's the pump, but let's start it up and try to move the hydraulics, see what happens. I've already looked down into the reservoir when the machine is running, and normally when the hydraulic system is operating normally, that stuff is swirling around in there. I mean, it's flowing back in and flowing out, and it's just a, you know, cauldron of hydraulic oil. And it was still in there. So, but anyways, let's start it up. We'll try to move the hydraulics a little bit, and that way you can get a feel of what's going on and why I kind of went with the decisions I'm gonna go with to hopefully get this fixed out in the field with nothing more than what I could bring with me. Let's get after it. Welcome to Man Time. So the deal was, we were trying to dig some outfalls out up here for the house pad. Once we had the forms in and stuff before the concrete and before a big rainstorm, I let my contractor use it. He made his way down this hill somehow. I think he kind of panicked and tried to use the, you know, hydraulics to lift himself back up the hill. Wasn't working. So let's start it up here. I'll move the hydraulics around a little bit. Let me get some of the stuff off of this loader. But I mean, we're gonna be listening for like cavitation, odd sounds coming from the pump, odd sounds coming from the hydraulics, stuff like that. Oh, and so somebody left the switch in the on position, and now the battery is completely dead, so that's nice. Well, the first step I'm gonna take here is trying to clean up a lot of this stuff. Actually, the first step that I did before I even came out here was read the manual, hoping that the manual is going to be able to tell me something. I've got a funnel with a nozzle on it to drain out the fluid from the reservoir here, but I don't know how much that is going to help me. Now, I did read something really interesting in the manual, and that's, there's a filter, I think, up here at the bottom of the reservoir where that might be the issue. But hard to say at this point. First thing I'm going to do is, I think, get this cooler out of there and then remove this soft line and try to get this fluid drained out of there and into a 5-gallon jug. I've got a bucket underneath of here. First thing you want to do, there's two big nuts on either side of this oil cooler. You lefty-loosey both of them out of there. Then this rotates out of the way. From there, you've got a couple of hose clamps for this, which is your return line to your pump. And now, I guess I'll just explain, you know, what I was feeling when the machine was actually running. I put my hand on the pump. It didn't feel like it was pumping. There was very little, like, feeling of any rotating assembly actually working in there. Now, I've had this whole front end assembly apart when I replaced the engine. You got to get all this stuff off of there. And I remember it being extremely difficult to get the pump out, get the drive shaft off, all that stuff. And you can see, well, you can't see, but I've actually got new U-joints on that drive shaft, because I didn't want to take any chances with it when I had it out of there. But there's four bolts going into the front of the crank, or the front of the engine on the crank, which then turns the pump. yeah, I just don't know what the problem is at this point. I'm really hoping that I take this hose off of here and nothing happens, because that would tell me there's a clog in this filter up here, and then that would mean my job and troubleshooting just got a whole lot easier. But I almost guarantee that's not going to happen, because that, again, is not my luck. All right, how do I get this off of there? I mean, the ground that I'm working on here is definitely not ideal. Yeah, that's a spline shaft that the drive shaft is connected to. That's not going to be our problem. Bolts to get the pump out are either side here and down over there. There's some bolts that hold this onto the bottom of this. That could be our problem. I think, yeah, I'm already seeing clean fluid coming out of here. So with any project like this, you want to be able to identify like what tools you're going to need and keep them right here, you know, at the point of use. Problem with this one is going to be, you know, there's no easy way to get any leverage on it to loosen it up with all this, you know, stuff in the way. Now I think I could maybe take this tube off, and heck, I might have to take it off anyway, just to get the pump out of there. The pump doesn't look like it's gonna come out of there very easily. But let's try to maybe get this started loosening. Maybe I can hit it with a hammer on the, let's see, righty, lefty. Okay. Got it started. And of course there's, you know, oh, well, looks like I need to have something on the back of it here. Okay, so both of these are probably going to be the same, but if I can get it started, loosened, might have a better chance of, you know, getting it to break free. Both of them are semi-broke free, except for the fact that, you know, they aren't, because there's a nut on the back here, or this is probably the bolt. Let's see here. Okay. Now the other thing I'm going to have to do is get the four, or I think two bolts off for the high pressure line coming off of the pump. But let's get one of these off anyway. They're going the right direction. A few things here. I was successful in both getting the pump out and getting this nozzle, and I got the pump out and I was like, yeah, that's probably not the problem, but I definitely wanted to get this out. This is just caked and full with sludge, like all around here. All of this stuff that was in there. Yeah, that's not good for a screen, right? So I'm going to clean this out. And then the pump. Let's see, where's the pump at? Here it is. So I did manage to get the pump out with the radiator still in there. Now the problem is, That very much sounds like a working pump. But the only way I can really am going to be able to tell is to take it apart. Because there could be a keyway that's just slightly engaging or sometimes engaging inside of here, and it could be sheared, and it just catches like its slow movement like that, and then if I were to, you know, put it back on there, start it up, that keyway would slip back down into its seat and no longer be pumping, although it's pumping now. Well, this is my life. Now I took apart the pump. Well, I didn't take it apart. I just I read the manual. I've got the full service manual for the machine, and basically it says there's only three seals that you can change, and if there's anything beyond those seals that's wrong with it, then it calls out for replacement of the pump. So, my options are fairly limited at this point, being reduced down to, hopefully it was the screen on this thing up here. If it's anything more than that, my hope for getting this machine running are very little. Now there is some metal up in here, so I want to clean out as much of that as I can. Various kind of debris. Splines in the drive shaft look good. I don't see anything else here that's really gonna give us too much of a problem. I think I lost a bolt somewhere. Well, there's just no good place to put a camera in this situation. But I've got the pump in. The only way that I was able to get this connected was to have one bolt just started, barely nut threaded on, have it sitting in there sideways, and then get the drive shaft on, turn the spline, and then push it together, and then get this other bolt in there. That is how it happened. So that was that process. Lots of fun. Now it's time to get the hardest hose on here and make sure that all of the mating surfaces are clean before doing that, of course. And let's see here, what's the easiest way to get this up and in here? Now the nice thing is, this hose was already hooked up on here. When I got this hose new for, you know, a replacement, it was really stiff, and it hadn't already formed its shape, right? So hopefully this time around I'll be able to get it to kind of line up on there. And you want to make sure to have, you know, your stuff, mating surfaces, cleaned off as good as you can, and that's going to be this surface here, of course, on the inside there where it seats up against that hose. And then once you've kind of got it where you're thinking you're going to be successful here, trying to figure out how to get stuff aligned in what order and where to position yourself to have a chance at this. Oh, this is fun. This is fun stuff. Okay. Well, I'm to the very last part. I'm trying to figure out how exactly this goes on here. It looks like there's kind of only one way that these screws are gonna line up in here. And I may as well just get this onto here. Yeah, I mean, that looks like the way that it's gonna go. Maybe take this off of here and then get it on. It's just so hard to try to figure out the right order of operations. Golly, what do I want to do here? I feel like I could get this started with this on here, maybe rotate it. Okay. Lined up. All right, man, I've got it filled back up with hydraulic fluid. I guess before I start it, I'll tell you what it was doing initially when it quit working. It would, the hydraulics would like move just a little bit, like to tell you like it was trying to do something, but nothing was there. Hopefully it was that screen. I didn't really do anything else. I took the pump off. I mean, when I was turning it, I actually put fluid down one side, spun it, and it pumped it out the other side, so I don't think that's the problem. Cleaned out that screen. Hopefully that was the issue. If not, what I can do is take this filter cover off, and you know, there's a bleed plug on the end of it. Maybe that does something. Let's see if it works first. Hopes are low. So that is doing exactly what it was doing when it quit working. Everything I've done today so far has been in vain. Down there in the comments, if you guys have any idea what is causing this, I'm going to start taking this filter housing out. And that filter is less than 2 years old. I replaced it. But what I can do here, I've got a bucket over there. I'm going to drain it, you know, what's in there. Just take the filter out and see if that doesn't do anything. Alright, so here's our filter housing. I'm gonna see what happens when I take the bleeder off. Whoa! Okay, so that's good clean fluid in there. And I wish I had something clean to put that in. So fluid is flowing, because this is clean. This is what I just put in the system. And I was looking down, you know, into the reservoir as it was running. Please tell me this is going to stop. So I got the filter out, and there was some fine kind of particulate stuff down in the housing of this, but I don't see, I mean, I don't see how this would be clogged. Maybe it is. I don't know. We're going to try it. We're going to try it by just putting this cover back on and seeing if we can't get some fluid just to bypass and see if this system doesn't work. Really strange, though. I was just digging stumps with it, you know, the weekend before, and it was working fine, you know. It's a mystery as to how it goes from working just fine to not working at all. other than just like a, you know, the little lift up sit down thing. I just don't get it. Okay, you guys make your votes down there in the comments. Is it just the filter? Should I have just started there? Did I waste all that time today? About to find out. Fluid is low, but if it sounds like it's cavitating, you know, I'll just go get more oil. Praying for rain. Well, that was pretty unfortunate. So what did we do? We took the pump off, we spun it, it looked like it was pumping oil. Cleaned that pre-screen out of the bottom of the reservoir, completely removed the filter from the main filter housing. I've looked up in here, I can just barely see like fluid slowly moving toward the feed line, that screen, going to the pump. I guess it's just a pump at this point. Man, that's a tough lesson to learn there. If there's anything else that I missed, down there in the comments. Otherwise, I'm going to have to order a new pump. It's got a Webster pump. I took pictures of the pump number and stuff. So hopefully that'll come in. I mean, I don't even have money to order one, so I don't know what I'm going to do at this point, but anyways, if you guys have any suggestions, down there in the comments. Get out there, have you some man time too.